Well, Joel, great to see you, and congratulations on Warrior. Awesome film.
Thank you.
Imagine that there was a lot of preparation, a lot to think about before you went into it. How did you decide to approach it?
Well, it wasn't so much my decision. I wanted to get involved in the movie because of Gavin, the director. I'd seen his other movies, and I wasn't really interested in doing a fighting movie if all it was a fighting movie, if that makes sense. I wanted to do the movie because it was a drama first. But Gavin was insistent that Tom and I were available. He wanted us three months early.
Yeah.
Which ended up being two. But he wanted us to get to Pittsburgh 2 months early. Simply because if we were going to play the characters, he also wanted us in the frame as often as possible when we were doing the fighting. So he wanted us to go and, you know, kind of just inject ourselves into the whole fight world, which we did for 10 weeks.
And the training?
The training was really intense, but fun. You know, like, I like a bit of a challenge like that. And so we literally got to Pittsburgh 10 weeks early. We were kind of welcomed, and I mean really welcomed, by this like group of fighters who I thought were going to be like, you know, who are these two actors
coming
to
Hollywood, tend
to be
types,
fighters? Because I guess there was a choice, you know. It's like, do you get two fighters and teach them to sell the character side of things, or do you get two actors and teach them to fight? And it was a big leap of faith for Gavin, because Tom and I, neither of us at the time really looked like we were in fighting shape, and the question of our athleticism was always there as well. There was sort of a physical audition that Gavin put us both through. But the training consisted of getting to the gym at 7 in the morning till about 3 in the afternoon each day, 6 days a week for 10 weeks. And doing a lot of conditioning, a lot of fighting, like a lot of Muay Thai, and for my character, a lot of jiu-jitsu. Because if you notice in the film, my character just gets the crap eaten out of him. Every fight, he's like, just, my character's a punching bag, and then manages through kind of his
intellect.
Patience, intellect, and stubbornness to kind of survive and wrap someone up in these kind of jiu-jitsu moves. So my character did a lot of jiu-jitsu, and we ate a lot of food, and we lifted a lot of weight.
So there are the results on that poster behind you. I don't know if you've seen. That's a very effective poster. Very, very good. Excellent.
Depending who you are. I really like my character to put a T-shirt on the poster.
No, I'm liking it just the way it is. But what happens when you stop doing all of that amount of training? You can't stop suddenly and do nothing. And I know you're fit anyway.
Yeah.
But doing that level, what happens?
Well, I think a couple of things happen. When you get to the end of a movie like this, I think we were so exhausted, you just kind of want to... You just want relief from that. You want to get away from it. Or the other thing that happens, which kind of happened to me, is I got a little bit addicted to the training. But, I mean, you just can't train that hard for that long. Because, you know, there was a couple of things that started to happen to me during the shooting where, you know, they were making us kind of eat so much protein and carb deplete, which you usually do for a fight, maybe, you know, for a couple of weeks. And we were doing, like, we did two blocks of 4 weeks of just shooting fights. And so you're not eating any carbohydrates, and you start to go a little bit
crazy,
you know, because your brain needs sugar. So I would go a little bit, I'd get a little bit kind of tetchy on set, and I'm pretty even tempered most of the time, and the stunt coordinator would see me getting all kind of edgy, and he'd just come up to me, and the solution was he would tell me to go eat a bowl of rice.
Carbs up.
What was amazing was realizing just what different foods, what effect they really have over your body when you're in that kind of
zone.
Condition, you know.
It was great.
I loved it. I had a great time. A lot of punches got through the guard, and we all got injured, and you know, but it was fun.
It's got Oscar Buzz. I love saying Oscar Buzz because you do it in inverted commas. And that's on top of the fact that you're in The Thing and you've got all these projects going back to back. Things are looking really good for you at the moment.
Yeah, things are good. I mean, I don't know. It sort of feels like things have kind of shifted, but then it doesn't really feel like anything's different. You know, like it's all just work.
Yeah.
And I mean, when I say work, I love it, and I'm having a great time. But the one thing I really do like at the moment is, for a long time, I think I've been a little impatient about the kind of opportunities that I want to have. You know, I've got a lot to offer and I want to do so many things, and I quite often sit around on set. You know, I joked with someone the other day, I quite often sit on set and I'm like, I want that guy's role, you know, which is a common thing for actors. You know, you want to climb the ladder, you know, and do the things that you think you can do. And what's good now, and it's really thanks to Gavin who directed this movie, and whatever the buzz that's come off this in the States, is that other workers sort of rolled on from that. And the cool thing now is I just feel like I can work a lot and I can work on the kind of things that I want to do.
Is Gatsby one of those things?
Yes.
You're very happy to be on it, loving your character?
I love it, yeah. And look, Gatsby for me is really interesting because one thing happens I noticed with Hollywood is when I started in making movies in Australia, I was always playing like really interesting characters, yeah, and supporting roles, which for certain reasons in screenwriting, I think supporting characters are always more interesting.
Yep.
I think central characters have to toe this real serious moral line, and so you don't have a lot of scope to play. And you know, central characters are often, for lack of better words, the more boring of the characters. And I feel with Gatsby that I'm going back to the kind of place I used to have in movies, which is, you know, Tom Buchanan is just a little bit more colourful a character than a lot of central characters.
Leo's got the boring character, hey?
Yeah, Leo's got
boring.
No, well, the great thing about Gatsby is every character's interesting. I think Gatsby is so kind of obsessive. And everybody has their flaws in Gatsby, which is great, you know.
Yeah. It's in 3D. A lot of people have sort of wondered why. What's your thoughts now that you're there, you're doing it and you're seeing it?
Oh, it's spectacular. It's a real feast. And I'm glad we're doing it in 3D, really. I mean, it's such a... the whole kind of... all the fabric and all the characters and the depth of the parties and... I mean, the richness of it...
Which Baz does so
is
well.
...is made even more rich by that technology. And, you know, and it's a real submersive thing rather than arrows flying at the screen, you know,
yeah,
the spectacle version of 3D. It's more of a... allows the audience to enjoy being inside the party rather than viewing it from a distance, I think. Mm. It looks cool.
Yeah, very cool indeed. Mm. How much longer are you here doing that, and then what's the next project for you?
I'm here till... We're shooting till Christmas. And then I don't know what I'll do next.
Wow.
Something fun.
You have been back to back, though. You've
yeah.
been shockers.
So oh, there's a bunch of stuff that...
rest.
There's a lot of things that are out there to do. I mean, we're putting a lot of focus on what we're doing at Blue Tongue.
Yes.
My brother and I are working on a project and...
You're still writing and creating.
Oh yeah,
work
doing
at the
same a lot
time.
Of writing and got quite a few things that I've been writing and have written, and hoping to get a couple of other things going next year, and hopefully work on a couple of things.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Warrior, what are people going to take away from it when they see it?
Well, it's sort of it's been described as a bit of a man cry movie. I mean, a happy. I like the term happy cry. I mean. Like happy cry, like well, there's movies that you feel inspired by, but it does tend to upset people. And I don't know. I think people. I mean, thematically, I think people take away the kind of the importance of family and the importance of kind of putting behind sort of past grievances. And it really is that kind of a story of a kind of a messed up triangle of a father and two sons, and how after 15 years they find their way back together, albeit physically rather than verbally, but that's the kind of family they are. The tough thing with this movie is, you know, I think, you know, mixed martial arts or the cage fighting thing, the UFC world or whatever,
yeah,
is kind of often judged as a very brutal sport.
Yes.
And yes, it is that. I mean, it is obviously that. I mean, two men fighting each other and imposing their will on each other in that way, it can be brutal. But this film is not just that, and it isn't even really about the brutality. But it has lots of cool fights in it. It does. The hard thing I find is that, you know, when they tested the film in America, they tested the highest amongst women in their 20s.
Really?
And it was like a score of like 95% or something, however the test scores work, but that sounds good, right?
Yeah.
And Gavin, the director, came and called me up and he said, "Oh, Joel, I didn't realise the whole time we were making a chick flick."
A chick flick.
Yeah. And, but it really grabs everybody, and I think Nick Nolte being in it, turning in such an inside-out, wonderful performance, and the story of Tom and I, and it sort of kind of resonates with a lot of different people, from very young people to older people, and I think it really is because the real core of it and the real strength of it is this family story, and its fighting is really just the garnish. You know?
I think you're right. Congratulations.
Thank
Rock's lovely to see you as always.
Thank you very much. You too.
Have fun on the rest of Gatsby and see you soon.
Thank you.
Take care.